I would say in this area, we're probably the highly dense area that has the most apartment complex throughout Houston and throughout, I would say throughout Texas.
This is an apartment community with people from all over the world that settle right here in Houston and Gulfton. This is the most diverse area of the most diverse city in America. And when you look around, you see that diversity.
This area is pedestrian oriented. Everybody walks to everywhere.
What you see is a lot of hardworking people, a lot of families. And this is the area where people come to when they first get to Houston that are looking for the American dream.
It's not safe at night. It's not safe at night to be out. I can just say that.
It's gotten to the point that where, there's no voice. There's nothing done.
Can things be better in the area? Yes. And that's the reason why we all get involved to see if we could make some changes.
We have to find ways in which we can engage, ways in which we can trust.
It's time for us to step up and help. The police can't do it by themselves, nor can the politicians or anybody that's in that.
We're taking Gulfton back. They're saying, we're fed up. It's time to take it back.
This is a part of Houston.
We started out being the Gulfton ghetto. The perception of anybody traveling through Gulfton to get from either the Galleria to Bel Air, they usually try to get here through here as fast as they can because either they're afraid or they don't like what they're seeing.
That's a great community, so many people, densely populated, a lot of immigrants, but our community.
They refer to this area, it used to be a District F at one point, and so we were District F, the forgotten area. Everybody's like, well, where are you living at in Southwest Houston? They're like, what? In Gulfton? So I see the inner beauty.
Gulfton is always near and dear to my heart. It had a name prior to what people used to refer to it, and I never accepted that.
The census, has a number, but, our immigrants sometimes don't like to fill out census. So just being in the apartment industry and having a total average of what would be an apartment, we would say we're about 88,000 strong in a 4-mile radius. So it's a pretty large population.
You've got it's probably one of the most diverse areas in the entire city. And in just a 1 square mile area of this area, you've got probably 20 different cultures, maybe more.
I would say, at least 30 to 40 apartment communities in this small area. It's so condensed because of the apartment complexes that are here, the communities that are like I said, if you go on any street, you see apartments. Of course, we're sitting in the only park in Gulfton, and we're trying to make a change and trying to get recognized, not be an eyesore for Houston.
This is a place where families come and convene. This is a place where kids come to play.
This is the only recreational area for the kids. So, if they live at the end of Gulfton, they have to walk 4 miles to get here.
Well, we don't like to be out in the night around here, especially with everything we see on the news. We were out, where was it? It wasn't too far from here, not too long ago. And then after we left, I knew that there was a robbery there. We seen it on the news, actually. It was a couple hours after we left. So we're like, yeah, that's why we don't want to be going out at night.
Overnight, a man was shot at a Southwest Houston apartment by a woman.
The Gulfton area, I know it gets a lot of negative press sometimes.
A man was shot in the arm and leg at a complex on Rampart in Gulfton. He was taken to the hospital.
In a carjacking in the Gulfton area, this happened about 4
The child was shot as they were walking home from a nearby store.
You can go to the park, you can go through the neighborhood, and there's a lot of things that are just, you know, eyesores or just things that have been not taken care of. The manicure, I mean, just if you just take a ride.
Shot two people in a drive-by in the Gulfton area.
About 12 to 15 shots.
I'm just basically here trying to see what we can do for our neighborhood and try to get attention, bring back the pride in Gulfton and get the people involved. If we're always going to be afraid, then there's not going to be a change. My beginning, you know, motherhood was very difficult for me. And, you know, me as a single mom, and I have a special needs daughter, and I was single at a point that, you know, wind up living in a park for 2 weeks. And, you know, just it went through the domestic violence type issue and survived. And so did she. You know, she's with me today. She's 40 years old. I'm passionate at the fact that, you know, it just, I feel that we can always do better.
We just have one common enemy, and those are people who seek to break into people's homes, to assault people, burglarize their property, commit homicides. Those are the people that we are standing against.
There is nowhere safe, nowhere that it says that I know of. But, you know, if you don't help deter the crime and help everybody, if everybody gave a little bit, then there'll be less crime. We lost that element, you know, back in the day, you know, where you grew up and you knew to respect your elders, you knew to do that. Now you're afraid to even address anybody because you're gonna be shot.
When you think about the engagement of the apartment community here, she's the go-to person, right? So when we are having to get information out to the different residents, there's culture barriers, there are language barriers. We go to people like Tammy because we know that the constituents trust her.
I've always had the philosophy that you don't run a property. You don't run an apartment complex. You either run a property for, you know, just a number, or you run a community and you make them all interact with each other where they respect each other and they will take care of each other. And you make them come together as neighbors. That's the true meaning of a community. Why is it that we don't deserve anything? Then I thought of us as a whole, as Gulfton in a whole, not just Hispanics, but every immigrant that came in, or every, refugee, every asylum. How dare you say my people? Who are my people? So I took on that challenge and said, these are all my people, so I'm gonna speak for them.
This area, it stands on its own.
Good morning, buenos dias a todos. Gracias por estar aquí presentes.
What we do is that we have an alliance against crime. It's called Alianza Against Crime. We go into the apartment communities because it's predominantly, you know, pedestrian oriented. We bring in resources in one full swoop.
Comida, sabemos que en la pandemia mucha gente ha perdido sus empleos. Aprovecha, hombre, comida gratis.
We'll bring in the food bank, will be as a partner. But with the initiative, bringing it into the residents, they are able to walk out their door and they're able to see the police officers there. The mounted patrol there, the SWAT team.
Right there, see or no? You like that? Yeah, a bit.
They're able to see HPD in a different way.
This is a way to bridge the gap. How do we do this?
My role is bridging HPD and the community. We're taking Gulfton back. I mean, so are the residents. We're having a march, you know, and that march is basically saying, you know, we're fed up. It's time to take it back, you know, that the police can't do it by themselves. You know, the mayor has an initiative, One Safe Houston. we're going to help them.
Stop the crime. You heard it here first.
We have a lot of people that are supporting it, so I'm hoping to see a large crowd.
I'm still in the fight.
Yeah. And we'll wind up here right at Baylen Park.
We got represented from state, local, and federal level. And we have all our citizens out here. But most important, it's about the community. I want to thank all the police officers, Chief Lewis from Metro, and everybody else. Thank y'all for being here. But Tammy and I, Kimon also, we started in the early 90s in this area. Dalton is not a stranger to me, so I'm just honored to be here.
When he was a rookie.
When I was a rookie. So look, the main point, because there's a lot of very important people that need to speak. I'm honored as chief of police, and I don't care what people say about crime in our city. The truth is, whatever's going on is not right in our city. We're gonna come together, and we're gonna stamp it out, and I mean that. So I'm honored.
If you go through the Gulfton, you see murals going up everywhere. We like to show the multicultural background of Gulfton, but what better way to do that is to, you know, bring life to the neighborhood, that way they can see and remember where they came from.
Every time you come to the park and every time you come to this community center, you will see this message. And I would like for us to unveil it now. So we're gonna get half on one side, half on the other.
Go ahead.
Golden Pride.
And it's time to take our Golden Pride and our park, our community, and we need to start working together. Remember, the police can't do this alone, neither can our mayor. So it's gonna take all of us. It's gonna take the whole village to be able to make this happen. So please, take pride in your park, take pride in your homes, and help and contribute. Don't be that silent voice. See something, say something. Thank you. Thank
you. See, I'm the brand new commissioner, so I'm trying to figure out what needs to be done.
Thank you so much.
Well, this is important.
Yes, it is. It's a long thing, a long time coming. You know,
Master plan.
Master plan. Yes.
Okay, where's Pollard?
My hair.
Master plan.
Master plan for
Master plan.
Yeah, that's what we're trying to put together. So
guess what?
What's up?
I'll do it.
Hey! We heard it here first.
Hey, okay. And look,
you heard it here first.
Hello, it's recorded.
These are the two witnesses.
We'll get together a 50,000 foot elevation master plan, and often after that, then you have to do the deep one.
Thank you.
But the top ones we do all the time.
All right,
cool.
So awesome.
I'm going to do the 50,000 foot master plan.
Yes.
We'll launch that with one of our own calls, and we'll see how long it takes.
Thank you so much.